back from technical difficulties. Sorry, guys. So sorry. Okay, so we have a special celebration because I have 69 followers. Oh my dog. Oh my doggy. Okay, I just gotta log in to our Final Fantasy again. I guess it's good that it wasn't like. Okay. Here we go. Play. Here we go. This should be better. Okay. Or not. I've never seen this. This is not good. It's not good. Dude, okay. There we go. That's better. That's way better. Derp. And then okay, I'm done with this for now. Okay, so that sucked, but let's see. Friend list. Okay, I guess not yet. Cast die. I'm not a huge fan. Augmented, sucked. Let's see. This has to work now. Yes. Whole set. Sick. That's true. The never-ending boss of Final Fantasy XIV is the inventory management. But look at this. This outfit. Dang. Nice. It's awesome. Okay. Hello, hello. How's it going? Little fellow with a wide-brimmed hat. He came through here. Bought passage on a supply ship. Funny little buggers. Lala Fells. Okay. Well, if Gigi left the city, it was not by the main gates. And the sentries at the airship landing have seen no one matching his description. Falcon's Nest? Fury take me. Must we return to that freezing pit of despair? Wheresoever Gigi goes, I will follow him and find him and embrace him as my son once more. However, I surmise our final destination lies far beyond the walls of said outpost. Indeed, there's but one reason he would return to those frozen wastes. To frolic in the snow and cast his worries to the winds. Really? He seemed in no mood to frolic when last I saw him. As I recall, he used his arcane powers to mend a vase, only to become morose and belligerent when it became clear to him that he was, in fact, a mammoth. One might even say he remembered what he was, remembered his purpose, and so he returned to Western Corythus, that famous breeding ground for heresy, where first we found him. Home to his heretic masters to share with them the intelligence he had gathered on the city. Sniff, sniff. At long last, the undeniable, the unquestionable, the unmistakable scent of heresy. What are we standing around here for? We have a heretic to catch. Inspector, I'm starting to think that Inquisitor's might not think very highly of our little girl. It is possible, but I would not presume to know his feelings ere he voiced them explicitly. Until such time as he does, we should endeavor to surreptitiously bring him round to the opinion that Gigi is a boy of pure heart and good intent. Subtly in all things, Nashu, that is the Mandervale way. Okay, now it's time to get some tombstones. Tombstone time. This is the right one, I think. You got Decipher. Okay. Nice. So we do this one, Praetorium, and then we'll go get the treasure. Oh no, we can't. Because I looked to see where the treasure was on the map, and it was like, in a place that's, I don't know where the heck it is, you know? Oh my gosh. Inappropriate. We'll zoom in on this one. A hedge mole. Oh. Percent. All right. Hmm. 3%. Dang. Well, that sucked.
Thank you.
74%. Percent. Okay. Dude. %. %60. Okay. $35. $24. I know. I was surprised.
And his name being Bonehart.
I know. I was like.
It just doubles down on what I said about them being the high school quarterbacks.
Yeah. Okay. Did I already? Okay, I guess From Albert. From Albert. Hello, I'm from Albert. Okay, let me do this one. Quest accepted. You have had news of Nidhogg? Alas, not. Our scouts range far and wide, but they have as yet found no trace of the great worm. We dispatched an elite unit of dragoons to reconnoiter the churning mist, but even they returned empty-handed. A pity. Fear not, Alphanod. We shall see the worm again soon enough. His words at Falcon's Nest attest to that. Indeed, he is like to come sooner than we would wish. I assume Ishgard's defenses are being bolstered as we speak? With all haste, I mean to call upon every able-bodied warrior at our disposal, from the knights of the four houses to the men and women of the watch. But I did not summon you to discuss strategy. What then would you have of us, my lord? I will speak plain. Now that Nidhogg is possessed of both of his eyes, no mortal force we can muster will repel him. That being the case, we must needs recruit an ally of equal strength. You speak of Ralsvigr? I do. To whom else could we turn? That he is Nidhogg's equal, I do not deny, nor can I name another, but convincing the reclusive creature to do battle with his own brood brother will be, how shall I put this? It will be no small undertaking, yes. Astinian's report was most particular about Hrazvilgr's unwillingness to involve himself in the affairs of men. But much has changed since your visit to Somal, and if there is even a chance that the dragon may be swayed, I must plead our case. Whatever price the dragon asks of me, I shall pay it. Such is my oath to defend the people of Ishgard. Come what may, my friends, the battle with Nidhogg will mark the end of my tenure as the acting head of church and state. Will you help me discharge this final duty? We will, my lord, though I fear our involvement offers no guarantee of success. Come then, we will depart at your leisure. Thank you, both of you. The city is yours, First Commander. My lord, we shall pray for your swift return. It gears me to impose upon you in this manner. Pray forgive us for disturbing your recuperation, Vidovner. I hope your wound does not pain you overmuch. Didst thou imagine me close to death? The thrust was deep, but not mortal. I will heal in time. You are the guest of honor at our conference, and we failed in our duty of protection. On behalf of Ishgard, I apologize unreservedly. I am a dragon, full grown, and thou thought to protect me, mortal? I was tempered by the fires of battle, ere thy great-grandsire learned to crawl. Thy words do remind me of a knight whom I called friend some thousand years past. He swore to defend me from harm and hardship. Would that we could return to that era of peace when man and dragon knew such comradeship. Would that our every effort to do so were not undone by ancient rancor. For a truth, there can be no peace while Nidhogg's shade yet lingereth. That much is plain, yet we lack the strength to banish him. Thus do we make for some all to beseech the aid of your sire once more. Folly, thou knowest as well as I, he will answer. A pity, but if it is folly to hope, I am content to die a fool. As hath ever been the way with thy kind, go then, but be warned. The shade's present hath driven its minions to frenzy. Thank you, Vidifner. We shall disturb your rest no longer. Okay, I'm gonna get some water.
She pulled on his hand with a devilish grin. She led him upstairs. She led him upstairs. Left him dying to get in. Forgive me, I'm trying to find my calling. I'm calling at night. I don't mean to be a bother, but have you seen this girl? She's been running through my dreams, and it's driving me crazy, it seems. I'm gonna ask her to marry me.
I kept you waiting. It's a wild, wild world, and you're a wild, wild girl. My sun's still shining, but it seems half the size, and it's a wild, wild world out here. Before my time you find me in the stars. skips